Yo everybody, this is Rock with the Great, aka the Toy Bookie, and in today's video we are coming to you with a diorama tutorial. In today's diorama tutorial, we are going to be talking about how to make a tree for your dioramas out of paper mache. Now I have a tutorial in the past on how to make trees out of XPS foam, so you can go check that one out if you'd like, but in today's video, this is super simple, super easy. This is like craft school stuff. In this video, I'm going to be making a base. You don't have to do the base, you could just do the tree, but I wanted to do something different with the base. So we start out, I got my dollar store foam board. You're going to cut it to whatever you want, because this is going to be the base. And again, if you don't need to do the base if you don't want to on this one, but I wanted to do a base. So you take your paper towel roll, that's what we're going to be using as the base of the tree itself. As you can see here, I am using the masking tape not only to tape the cylinder to the bottom of the base, but also I'm adding like some vines and stuff on the bottom of trees. Not all trees go right into the ground, you know, perfectly. So I'm just building up a little bit of some vinage.
Oh, hey! Enjoying that free content? Hit the like button, leave a comment down below, even if you have nothing to say! The YouTube algorithm would love it, and you'd be supporting my channel so I could bring you more free content. Thanks for watching. Get back to the video.
Now, once you have everything taped down and you got your details in place with your masking tape, we're going to make the solution that we're going to use for our, basically our paper mache. So you just take normal kids glue, PVA glue, normal water, and you're going to do, I would do like half-half. Right? But then you're going to just mix it together and make sure it's pretty watery, but also pretty thick. Like, make it nice and thick. I believe you could also use some Mod Podge for this step, but a Mod Podge is more expensive than, you know, the PVA glue. Now, this was the hardest part for me because I was kind of winging it. I was just going for it, like how I remembered paper mache from high school and stuff. So I was really in the blind over here, and it kind of was a trial and error, and this project almost didn't happen because I thought I messed it up and I ruined it, but I'll talk about that later. But so now, all you're going to need is old paper. Try the thinnest paper you can. This is some old pamphlets that they give out for, you know, some stores. I forgot what they're called. I'm tired. I'm sorry, guys. This is like the weirdest, messiest part. It's going to feel like you're doing it wrong, but you grab the pieces, you wet them really good, make sure the glue and everything's on, and then you put it onto the tree and you squeeze it, and you just gotta mold it to, you know, where you want the pieces to go. So just keep molding it. It's gonna be wet for a long time, and this part lasted. So where I thought it was messed up, I was like, oh, it's so wet, it's not gonna dry. It was not drying. I was trying with the blow dryer and everything. But what I had to do was just, once I had all my paper mache on this item, I literally just put it in my garage and forgot about it for like a day or so. And it fully dried and it was exactly what I wanted. So this is the part where you really can't mess this one up, because any like a layer or wrinkle or anything is good for the tree, because trees are all messy looking anyway. So, the hardest part was just thinking that it was a failure and this wasn't even going to be a video until a little bit later, when I just put it in the garage. It fully dried and it was nice and hard and it was exactly everything I wanted. So be patient with this. It's the longest step, is just letting it wait and letting it fully dry for about a day. I almost forgot this, but I also put a layer of napkin. So I took a very thin napkin, like I opened it up, you know, the napkins that you buy, like the, you know, normal napkins. And I opened it up into the four squares and ripped the little sheets of those. And I think this was the perfect consistency for the top of the tree I was going for. And you'll see later on when it's painted, it's got like a really good, it's got a really good texture. So you don't have to do this part, but I think it was a really good, for the texture of the tree that I was going for. All right, so now I let this sit overnight. It's fully dry. And now we're gonna spray paint this guy black, just for like the under base coat, and then we're gonna dry brush on top of it. So let's go spray paint this guy.
light sprays, don't overdo it, and let it dry and we'll come back.
Again, I have to say how pleasantly surprised I was. I thought this was going to be a failed project, and with just a little bit of patience, it fully dried, and it was really nice. I like it. And that's also, you could see I have a tutorial coming where this tree I make out of the foam that people make dioramas out of, that's what you see in the background right there, where I was comparing them. That is a tutorial that's coming on the channel also. So where I thought this project failed, I went and did another tutorial because I wasn't going to let it get me down. And so I filmed that tutorial while I thought this one was not going to dry and it was a failure. So then when it wasn't a failure and you know, the tutorial actually, the tree dried and I was happy with it, and I started doing this process that you're seeing right here, dry brushing, then I decided to just continue with the project. So for dry brushing, I have a whole video on it in depth, but you're just going to want to take a little bit of paint, a dry brush, and you try and get a little bit of the paint off. I am pretty liberal with it, so I just don't care, because again, this is messy. Like, you want it to look messy, you don't want it to look too even. I take a light brown because I forgot that trees really aren't brown. Trees are just like tan or gray, which is really weird when you think about it. This project really opened my eyes. I was like, wait, we always make brown trees in the diorama, community, and it's got, like, they're not brown. So I believe I make it even lighter later on, or at least I do in my other tree tutorial. But just, I'm dry brushing, and as you can see, the dry brush really takes the nice details, and it just makes them pop. And it's like you could see all those details, and it's starting to look realistic now. And I was really, really happy with how this came out. And I might do some more of them in the future and maybe make like a whole little thing that the bases all snap together.
And here we are, just showing you guys that there are so many different ways to make trees. They are very easy. And again, they're usually just background pieces, so they don't have to look super detailed or even crazy, because again, your cameras should blur them out in the background most of the time. So this is the foam, again, as made as easily as possible. And here is the sort of paper mache way to make it, with adding a little bit of more detail to the bottom, but you don't have to do all that stuff. And there you go. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you figure out which way you like to make your trees. And just again, if this shows you anything, it's just have fun and go out and make it. And it doesn't matter. Make up your own tutorial and make your own way of doing it, because there is no right or wrong way to make crafts and diorama, because it's all about what you like. So thanks for watching, guys. This is Rocco the Great, aka the Toy Bookie, and we are signing out. Stay great, guys. Peace.
Do you like toy photography? Do you like tricks and tips? Then follow me over at the Toy Bookie on Instagram. Are you into art? Graphic design? Sexy Rocco? Follow me at Rocco the Great. Bye.
I'm a dying.